I was not into games since my childhood. The golden times when videos and games were two different things. But with time, the revolutionary era of video games came into existence, and everyone started playing these video games and loved it. But I never liked video games because I was used to enjoy stories more than playing games. I was kind of kid who likes watching people playing but personally hated holding the joystick and actually playing as a character. Back then, I was stubborn. I was ignorant. I was a fool. I was Binod. But then, one fine day, long time ago, I saw my friend playing Spider-Man in PS5. That gameplay gave me hope. It gave me power to imagine and swing like my favorite superhero of all time, Peter Parker, aka Spider-Man. Before this, I admired every live-action version of Spider-Man. But my first love for the character arc of this superhero was always Tobey Maguire's Spider-Man. I don't know what magical powers he possessed, but he always inspired me. He always made me see the superhero inside me. A superhero interpretation I can relate to. A geek, a nerd, losing his best moments in life to save the best moments of others by saving their lives. Swinging in action, fighting and defeating criminals. Doing all of his amazing stuff, but not too amazing to be honest. Because Sam Raimi's Spider-Man trilogy focused on the man behind that Spidey mask, Peter Parker. An absolute brilliant but loser guy, struggling with his life by prioritizing things. Being Spider-Man for a long time doesn't pay bills, but with great power comes great responsibility. And this responsibility is not just an option for Peter, it's his gift for the greater good, for a greater responsibility, for making a better society. I always loved this version because this made me see the Peter Parker within me, the hero in all of us, the hero who takes his stand even while struggling in his personal life, the hero who never gives up. The man who is just a nerd from his class, wearing up his suit and swinging in the New York City, helping people, saving lives, defeating the criminals. His relationship with his Aunt May, a mother figure who helps him emotionally by supporting him even after knowing that he doesn't have a job or a perfect life. For her, he is just a kid, just like our families. No matter what we gain or lose, they will love us unconditionally. Care for us unconditionally. Support us unconditionally. They are our real strength, to be honest. And Spider-Man PS5 showcased this with more honesty and sincereness. The more grounded relationship between Peter and his Aunt May. Peter doesn't ask her for money, but she knows that his kid needs money to pay his bills, showcasing how caring and loving Aunt May is. Asking to Peter if everything's alright, helping him to feel less stressed and relaxed. Giving him extra comfort to help him fight his own demons inside him. She says, "It's okay." To help him rise and swing into the action on his gifted mission of saving New York City. Even in the end, she reveals that she knew that Peter was the guy swinging in the spider suit, and she did worried about him these many years. But while worrying inside for Peter, she always felt proud of him for saving all the people, their families and friends. Peter's love interest Mary Jane in this game, not just a random confused girl but more understanding, mature and honest reporter who is sincere at her work. Their love story is not even a love cake but showcasing the thin cream of memories they shared in the past, showing without actually showing their love. Peter loves her deep inside and Mary Jane loves him inside too. Both lovebirds showing each other's love and care for each other by not loving each other. Two beautiful colors put together into a single water drop. But these colors are not mixing up to result a new color. This is the greatness of their love. Both respecting each other and their lives, accepting each other's truths and trying to balance the heart and brain of their relationship. Peter Parker amazed me when I saw him helping his mentor Dr. Octavius on his project. This made me remember that Peter is a brilliant student of science, but obviously lazy, or I must say, busy swinging around the streets of New York. This single scene showcased the cool part of Peter Parker. He's not just a loser guy, he's a brilliant science student and he idealizes Dr. Octavius as his mentor, as an inspiration, as a wannabe role model because of Doctor's genius intellect and does all in his power to help him improve in his project. He even accidentally reveals him that he is the Spider-Man and felt proud of himself when his role model complimented him and promised him to not tell to anyone about this. But in the end, I felt emotional and cry when Spidey lost his beliefs on Doctor and his principal. Despite of knowing the truth, he tried to kill Peter. That scene was so deep and emotional, a point at which every relationship breaks, even if it's your mentor. You have to walk on the path of righteousness as always. Before making us to eat a wonderful dish, the makers of this game made us to taste some yummy desserts and character developments were up to the mark. They introduced Officer Davis before showing us his son Miles Morales and his mom. Officer Davis, a great cop who saved Spider-Man's life by crashing his own police car. I felt it when he showed up like a hero to save Spidey. I felt it when he lost his life saving people by pushing them away. I felt it when Miles cried. I felt it when Peter approached to Miles to talk to him. I felt inspired when Miles punched Spider-Man when Spidey insisted him to do so that he can learn to fight back. I felt inspired when Miles saw Peter as an inspiration. I felt inspired when Miles saved Spider-Man. I felt motivated when Spider-Man didn't actually give up and arrived to fight Dr. Octopus even without knowing whether he can defeat him or not. I felt great when Miles learned to fight for himself. I loved the scene when a radioactive spider bit Miles Morales, making me more curious about the future of this game. Not every character is written well, but is executed well in order to make a good story. Each and every character and the relationships between them are beyond any live-action movie. It was better than any interpretation of Spider-Man till now. Back then, I was not a great fan of playing video games, but this game made me to hold up a joystick and start playing due to its great graphics of this gameplay and a pure sense of satisfaction. I literally used to swing in the streets for hours to feel like my Spider-Man inside the game. And if you ask me, Spider-Man PS5 is a perfect animated movie of Spider-Man because of its great story building and twists. But can I watch this as a movie? Yes, you can. Here's where game movies come into the picture. For curious minds like you, I have provided the links of these game movies in the description. Check out if you want to. So PS5 Spider-Man is the best Spider-Man, to be honest. A cool but busy Peter Parker and a cool and great superhero. The best of both, to be specific. And I was curious to see the bonding between Peter and Miles after watching to the end credit scene. I felt amazed and surprised. Didn't expect Miles to show up his powers to Peter this openly. And then, raise a new spider hero, swinging over the New York with the real spider. A guy who possesses the power he didn't ask for. A guy who has to be responsible for his powers. A side boy more than just a sidekick. When Peter leaves New York for a few weeks, he has to prove himself to the New York and to his mentor Spider-Man. Initially trying to wear Peter's shoes, but after realizing he creates his own identity. A new suit, his own design, not copying any superhero. He starts from helping people, tries to support them, becomes the friendly neighborhood Spider-Man of the New York City. Miles is the best example of the best version in all of us. Life doesn't give you a choice. It just gives you a responsibility, to which you have to take stand and prove yourself. You may lose some people. Some people may lose you. You may leave your enemies behind in the path towards making a better future for yourself and your people. You will face many challenges, end up knowing darker truths about your loved one, but keeping on to do what you started is necessary. By the end of this game, Miles Morales proved himself to the people of New York City and his mother. His mother first worried about him, but accepted his destiny and supported him. This is how great stories are made, by showing their struggles, challenges, twists, affecting the man behind the mask of Spider-Man. That is why I say Spider-Man of PS5 are the best version of Spider-Man up to date, and is a perfect animated movie, to be honest. The storytelling is so good that you can literally watch the cutscenes as a complete animated movie. For Tobey Maguire Spidey fans and the Amazing Spidey fans, I have provided links to these game movies in the description. So always remember, my friend, with great power comes great responsibility. Signing off, Skill Beings.